Hello everybody and welcome to this briefing at the end of the third week of term here at St Dunstan's, and I hope you're all keeping well. I'm pleased to say that there hasn't been another confirmed case of COVID-19 yet or this week in the building, which is obviously a very good thing. And actually we've been able to resume certain elements of normality, which has been nice to see. So we begun this week with our languages theme, and my thanks to the languages departments who have instructed a whole range of activities across the junior school and senior school, which was really lovely. Our FORDA programme in the senior school started up this week, and I know the FORDA programme begins in the junior school next week as well. So signs of real normality starting to come back into the school, albeit of course still in very different circumstances. Earlier this week I hosted the first meeting of the Diversity Working Group, which was a group I wanted to set up in light of recent events in America, and a lot of dialogue that had happened before the summer that I felt very strongly needed to be revisited from bringing together a whole range of different stakeholders. So we actually had an hour on Teams with a whole range of different people, current parents, former parents, old Dunstonians from across the generations, and current staff as well. And it was an incredibly fruitful discussion about all the things that we do very well at St Dunstan's, and we do a number of things very well in the area of diversity and inclusion, but also an acknowledgement that what we really now need to do is conduct a full audit of every element of life across the organisation, and use that audit as a tool to create an action plan for how we get even better in terms of our representation of the diversity of the community in which we live, our inclusion and celebration of diversity in its many different forms. And that audit will begin in earnest over the course of the next few weeks. I look forward to keeping you apprised of how that develops. One of the other great pleasures I had this week was to attend the Year 7 Bushcraft trip. So this is the trip that we do annually with all of our new Year 7s. We pack them off to a survival course in the woods, and this year we weren't able to do that as a residential trip, but we have been able to do it for 2 days out, and it was really lovely to get down there and see all those boys and girls just enjoying being outside, enjoying the fresh air and being back with their friends, and hopefully that's symptomatic of a larger sense of relief from across the pupils of being back with their friends again over these last few weeks at St Dunstan's. To update you on a few of the COVID-19 matters, if I may. Firstly, thank you to Year 4 and your patience as you've been off self-isolating for 2 weeks. I know the remote provision has gone very well, but it's not the same as being in school, so thank you for your patience with that. Thank you also to parents and students for all of the adjustments that you make to your daily routine in order to fulfil what we expect of you in order to keep the sites COVID secure. What I would say, please, to parents, when you're coming onto the site and on the drive, please maintain social distance or wear a mask. It needs to be one or the other. There's I suppose inevitably over the last few weeks that things erode slightly, expectations erode. Please can I use this as a timely reminder to either wear a mask or to maintain appropriate social distance on the front drive, and certainly when invited into the school buildings. And just to clarify the position with masks, I think last week it wasn't very clear. Junior school children do not need to wear masks. Senior school children do need to bring in at least one, if not two, masks a day to wear in the corridors and communal areas. The hybrid teaching continues to be a real struggle. I know I've said this every week, but it really does continue to be a challenge for us, and for teachers in particular who effectively are trying to manage two classes, one class at home and one class in school. It is difficult and resource heavy. Please can I emphasise once again, there are three categories of people. Either a child is sick and therefore needs to be in bed and getting well and then coming back into school when they're better. Or there is a child who is self-isolating at home because of various reasons, but is well enough to join in live teaching, in which case they are welcome to join that provision. Or thirdly, they're well enough to be in school and therefore they're in the classroom. There's no other category, and please do respect that if they are unwell, they need to stay at home and stay in bed, not to engage in the remote learning programme. That's designed for people who are self-isolating. Lastly from me, I want to just flag to year 11 parents. I know it's a very, very challenging year for year 11 students, in particular looking at these trial exams that are coming up and the importance that they might play in their end of year GCSEs. And the landscape is challenging. I've spoken with a lot of year 11s. I know they're very unsettled. So I am speaking with the whole year group on Monday, and I've also opened that up as an opportunity to speak with all of you at 6:30 through Teams. So I hope many of you can make that session. If you're coming to the Welcome to St Dunstan's or Discover St Dunstan's event earlier that evening, don't worry, I'm going to cover those points about Year 11 exams in that session. So don't worry about that. For those of you who are interested in these things, there are lots of videos being posted on our website at the moment, lots of new videos, mainly for prospective parents, because a lot of them can't get into the school to see it as they would normally. So they're quite interesting, and there are a number of them for you to have a look at. So do, if you've got a spare moment this weekend, do a browse on our website and look at some of those videos. I think you'll find them enjoyable. So that's it from me. I hope you have a really good weekend. I look forward to speaking with you again at the end of another busy week next week. Thank you.